Welcome to Your Bookkeeping Matters. I'm Lisa Turner, bringing you short and snackable weekly episodes on bookkeeping and business matters in an easy to understand way so you can be in control and confident that you know your bookkeeping matters. Let's dive into this week's episode. Welcome back to another fresh episode of Your Bookkeeping Matters. Now, at the time of recording this episode, over in My Practice Accounted For You, we're elbows deep in preparing and sending out our clients' monthly and quarterly BAS, which is Business Activity Statement. And part of this process, we share a report bundle with the client called Know Your Numbers. So it got me thinking this would be a great topic to share with you around knowing your numbers and what it actually means when us bookkeepers and accountants say you need to know your numbers. Firstly, if you're new to the show, welcome. I'm super excited to have you with me today. And when I see the show growing and being shared around business owners, it truly lights me up because I absolutely love teaching business owners more about their financials, taking the stress and overwhelm away, both here through the pod and through our fully done for you services over at Accounted For You, where we take care of all the daily nitty gritty and keep you on track with all the things you need to do financially so you can focus on top level numbers and leveraging them to grow and enjoy the business you've built for yourself. Okay, so this know your numbers, I say it a lot, and I'm sure you've heard it around as well. It can be a pretty broad topic, so it's important to have context. When you're looking at your Facebook ad spend and you need to know your numbers, it's different to know your numbers when looking at your product levels and different again to when you're looking at your business financials, your business profit and loss, your business's financial health overall. And there's the key word, financial health, and why I wanted to go through this important topic with you today. To know how your business is going, you need to know your numbers. If you don't know how you're doing financially and on an up-to-date, accurate basis, don't fool yourself into thinking you know your numbers because you have money in the bank or because you're paying your bills on time. If you're not looking at real time, as in recent, accurate data, you don't know the big picture. And this is things such as if you're being profitable, if you've got enough money saved for your BAS, if you're going to be able to pay wages next month. These kinds of crucial things to keep your business going and out of trouble. And it's not only seasoned business owners who need to be across this, because you might be thinking, hey, hardly any of those numbers you mentioned are relevant to me right now. Fresh business owners, those only recently starting out, you also need to know your numbers. It's simply different ones which are integral to your success and helps you reach those same levels the seasoned owners are at, where they know different numbers. I feel like know your numbers gets thrown around and sometimes, well, has become a bit of a buzzword, but when I use it, it's because knowing them will literally help you get where you want to go, reach your goals, have money in the bank to pay your BAS and tax bills, keep your physical or virtual doors open. This is what you want to do in your business. And while numbers are pretty much my day-to-day and I love them, numbers aren't only for us number crunchers. It's what you as a business owner can use to make great and strategic decisions in your business. Us trusty bookkeepers and accountants can put all the numbers together for you and work with you to get them right, but it's still your job and always will be to be across key numbers because, like I've said earlier, your numbers show you how healthy your business is, and checking in on your numbers, knowing them, well, it's a bit like a health checkup. To give you a quick example of doing a little health check, each couple of weeks, I have some key numbers, important numbers to me, that I plug into a spreadsheet I've created for myself of numbers I use to make decisions and make sure I have money aside to meet my obligations, such as how much super I have to pay for my team, how much GST my quarterly BAS is up to, and I check I have those amounts saved. Another one of the key figures is my revenue for the month to see how I'm tracking against my goals. And putting these numbers together gives me a great snapshot of how healthy my business is at the particular point in time. Do I have funds to cover what I owe? Am I meeting my sales goals? And this health check can be as simple or as big as you like. If you aren't doing these little health checks along the way, and for example, a big BAS bill popped up and you didn't have any money saved, well, you could imagine how stressful it would be in that situation. We do monthly estimates in between BAS lodgements for our clients so they can keep on top of it. It helps them know their numbers. Okay, so we've covered off why it's important to know your numbers and what it means. You need to know your numbers to be able to keep on top of upcoming payments, cash flow bumps, important ATO or tax office amounts. Are you thinking, yes, but what are the key numbers I need to focus on? And you'll be surprised to hear it's a super typical finance response of it depends. So I wanted to run through quickly a few key financial metrics or numbers every business owner should be aware of, because these are the building blocks or the foundational numbers you need to know. And then there are also ones that depend on what are important to you. First up, revenue or sales, whichever you call it. While this particular number is no indication of how healthy or profitable your business is, sales are the lifeblood of your business, and you definitely need to know your revenue and understand where it's all coming from, the different revenue streams you might have. That could be you have wholesale and retail. That could be you have digital products and done-for-you products is what I mean by the different revenue streams. So not only knowing your top-level revenue total sales, if you have different areas it comes from, make sure you know the different revenue streams totals as well. Next, you need to know your expenses, both your fixed and variable ones, because they are the two types of expenses. Fixed are generally the same each week or month and don't change based on how much you've sold of your products or services. And those variable expenses change based on how much you've sold. Things like your cost of goods, the materials for your products. You can dive back to an earlier episode, understanding your fixed and variable spending, to learn more about these two different types so you can get a better understanding of how your expenses can be split up. But expenses overall, you need to know how much of each type you have so you can be aware of what is normal for your business. And if it goes up or down, you can change other things you're doing accordingly to cover those higher expenses, to make sure you have enough aside for bigger ones popping up and things like that. My next key number you need to know is net profit, which is profit after all your expenses. If you're running a $1 million business with zero profit or a loss even, it's not great, hey? So it's pretty clear why you need to know your profit. If someone tells me their revenue was $800K, I want to know what the profit is, because they might have spent $795K or $795,000 on Facebook ads to get the $800,000 in sales. And they only have $5,000 left to spend on other areas of the business and pay themselves. And if you have a product-based business, you also need to know another profit, which is your gross profit, and this is your sales less your cost of goods or your variable costs. To make sure you've got profit after making or buying the goods to resell, because if you're buying or making goods and it costs you $100 and you're selling it for $105, you've only got $5 gross profit, which again doesn't give you much room to move with in terms of $5 for all your other costs like your wages, your phone, your software, but you get the idea. Profit is a key metric and number to know. One of the most important numbers you have to be across is your taxes, and I'm talking GST, goods and services tax, and income tax. Those are the two big ones here in Australia. There are others, so if other ones are relevant to you, make sure you're across those as well. You need to know these numbers on a regular basis, and that could be weekly, monthly, whatever works for you. Know where you're at with them on a top level estimate, of course, and make sure you have funds aside for them so you can pay them when they're due, so your business can keep going and growing. And the last one is, and it depends. And I mean, it depends on what's important to you, your business, your goals. It might be your Facebook ad spend that you want to keep an eye on. It might be your Shopify subscription costs. It might be your wages. Is it the thing that you spend the most money on each month? Well, then you should know this number each month. There are plenty of different numbers that could be important to you that you need to know. And it depends also on your industry, what stage your business is at. So work out what numbers are important to you and be across them. But we've been through those key ones, the revenue, the expenses, the profit, and the taxes. They are very big numbers you need to know. I don't want you to be thinking now, gosh, I have to be a financial expert to be across this. It's not the case at all. It's more you need to be able to get to these numbers, either from your accounting software, from your bookkeeper. It's about learning and empowering yourself what the key numbers are for you and where to get them from, and embracing them as important tools in your business. And going through keeping records to be able to know these numbers and ways you can track them is something I train you in my course, Bookkeeping Matters Blueprint, which is a foundational course, or for a better word, training for new business owners, or if you've been DIYing your books for a while and want to get a better understanding overall. Because as a business owner, it's something you need to set up from the start, tracking your numbers, and keep on top of recording and tracking the numbers for both yourself and because you need them for your accountant come tax time. Plus, it's important information in the early days to help you grow, to see where you're going, how things are tracking. I created this course, Bookkeeping Matters Blueprint, from working with so many new business owners who came to me to start taking care of their books after being in business for a while and didn't know what they'd needed to be doing from the start, didn't realize they were supposed to be paying for GST, didn't know what a profit and loss was or where to find their sales figures, didn't know they could keep track of their expenses even when they weren't yet profitable. All these key numbers and things they didn't know, and I am so super passionate about helping make financials or numbers simpler for business owners. So I would love you to join me in this training, which you can jump on the waitlist over at accountedforyou.com.au/BMB to learn a little more about it and know when you can next register to join the next training round. Those who've been through this training have said it's transformative. They aren't overwhelmed anymore. They're confident and able to move forward with their business and their numbers and saving and selling at a profitable price point. So many different things they have learned from doing this training to know their numbers. And I hope you now have a better understanding of what know your numbers means when I say that or someone else in finance says that. It's not a popular buzzword or catchphrase. It's a strategic approach to being an informed business owner and keeping your business healthy, embracing and regularly checking your numbers. Even if you outsource your books to a team like us, those key numbers are important to you and what helps drive your decision making, your growth, your success. And I want you to know these numbers so you can have your business be everything you want it to be. And if this episode has now got you strategically thinking about how you can learn more about your numbers, yes, again, please jump on the Bookkeeping Matters Blueprint waitlist if you feel like this is for you. Or if you have any questions, feel free to DM me on Instagram. I love chatting and answering questions. But thanks so much for joining me in this episode. I'll be back with you next week. I'm so grateful for you and sending you all the positive and fun vibes for a brilliant year ahead for you and your business.